Let's face it, quality matters, and a film look adds a layer of professionalism to your videos that can really set you apart from others. In this video, I'm going to show you guys how you can achieve a film look in DaVinci Resolve. So for starting out here, I just have my footage opened up in the color tab down here, and I haven't made any edits to it yet. So now the first thing I'm going to do here is I'm just going to create two more nodes for us to work with, and you can do that by selecting your node here and pressing Alt or Option S, and we will create two nodes with that. So now on the first node here, the first thing we're going to do is add a color space transform to this node. Now with this color space transform, we have to go in and adjust our input color space as well as our input gamma. So for this one, I shot this on Sony S-Gamut3.cine, and I shot it on S-Log3. But obviously for this one, you want to input whatever footage you are working with, so just make sure you put that in there correctly. But for the output here, we're actually going to come down to DaVinci Wide Gamut for the color space, and then for the gamma, we are going to do DaVinci Intermediate. Now this is the one I normally do because I find it gives me a lot of room to play around with when I get creative with my colors. But by all means, you can come in here and change and work in whatever color space you want to. So for example, if you wanted to do an ACES workflow, you could go ahead and do that. Or if you just wanted to come down and do Rec 709, you can come and do that as well. I like DaVinci Wide Gamut because of the extra room it gives me to play around with. So now I'm going to skip this node for right now, and then we're going to come into this last node here, and we're going to add another color space transform. And now for our output over here, like I said, we had the DaVinci Wide Gamut as well as the DaVinci Intermediate. So now we are going to set that as our input here. So we have DaVinci Wide Gamut and DaVinci Intermediate. And now for the color space output here, we are going to come down to Rec 709. And then for our gamma, we are going to use Cineon Film Log. And the reason we're going to do that is because we'll add a node after this. And what we're going to do is come into our LUTs over here. And now there is a folder inside of here for film looks that DaVinci Resolve has made for this. And these ones all work in the Cineon Film Log Rec 709 color space. So now, as you can see, they have given us quite a few different film looks for us to go with here. And then if you want to check any of them out, you can see you can just kind of hover over them to see what they look like. So you can select the one that looks best for your footage. I'm actually going to go with this one right here and drag that over into our node. And you can see that's already doing quite a bit for our look in terms of actually getting a film look out of this. Now, because I did expose to the right for this, I'm actually going to come in and use this node and just adjust my exposure here. So I'm going to bring that down by about there. So now, as you can see, this LUT here is actually giving us a pretty good look already, and is already giving us a pretty big step towards a film look. So I'm just going to close out of that LUT tab now. And now, real quick before we move on too, I'm actually going to start applying some labels to these nodes just so that we stay organized. So now, if you want, you can start getting creative with the look and actually kind of make it your own. So for example, any creative thing you want to do or any correcting adjustments you need to make should be done between these two CSTs here. So I'm going to create another node here. So for example, now with this, if you wanted to do something like, say, add a LUT to this, we can add a LUT. I'll just use one from Triune Digital here. We can apply that. So now, as you can see, we're kind of playing around with different creative colors that we want to go with here. Or, you know, you can, of course, do it yourself as well. So we can come in here, and let's say we wanted to add a little bit of blue into our shadows because there's already a lot of orange in this image. So we can create some color contrast with that and just get like a nice subtle effect with that. And of course, you can make any other adjustments you want here. Create as many nodes as you need. For example, one more thing I think I'm going to do here is just bring the color temperature up just a little bit to bring a little bit more warmth into the image. But that is pretty much the color grading part of this done. But now let's actually dive in on how to actually make this look more like film. So after our codec 2383 LUT here, I'm going to create another node after that and bring that over here. And now with this node, what we're going to do is add a halation effect. So you can click and drag that into there. And now as you can see, this is actually a pretty strong effect. You can see it kind of affecting quite a bit of the backdrop there, which I'm not a big fan of. So I'm just going to click on the View Isolated Regions, and I'm going to bring the threshold over a little bit until it's mostly just the main highlights of the image, just like that. And so you can see what that is doing to our image here. It's just kind of adding a nice subtle halation effect, mostly around the light here, but a little bit in my skin tone as well. But now after that, we're going to do one of my favorite parts of the film look, and we're going to add another node, and now we're going to add the film grain. So you can click and drag that effect into that node, And now in here, you can kind of go with whatever preset you want to do, or if you just want to customize it yourself, feel free to come in here and start playing around with the sliders. For me, for this shot, I'm just going to choose the 35mm here, and then I'm just going to bring the opacity way up just to make it a little bit more obvious. And now hopefully this is actually showing up on YouTube, but you can see the before and the after with that. So now feel free to kind of play around with this however much you want and get the desired effect you need. But that is kind of the main bulk of everything right there. And with that, we pretty much have a completed look here. And you can see that basically just with, you know, these three notes here. So we have our Kodak LUT here, as well as our halation and our film grain. You can see that we've actually created a pretty nice looking film look in DaVinci Resolve with just a couple nodes here. Now, one other thing I like to do is as a last node here, we can come into our blur settings here and we'll bring that down just one notch, and that will just sharpen the image and it actually brings out the grain a little bit better, which I really like the effect that it does, just to kind of give that little bit of extra clarity to the image. And so obviously, like I said, feel free to mess around with everything in between these two CST nodes here. That's where you can really make this look your own. And then everything after it here is just going to be that film look to really take it to that next level. But that pretty much does it for this video. If you guys like this video, please consider liking and subscribing. If you guys have any other video ideas that you'd like me to cover or any tutorials that you would like me to do, please let me know in the comments. But with that, I hope you guys have a great day. See ya.